District leaders gather at the Kabarole District Council chambers, their faces filled with concern. The room buzzes with whispers and tension as they discuss a pressing matter. Gideon Ruta, a councillor from Kasenda sub-county, passionately expresses their demand for the government to bring home the body of Private Sabiti Wilson, a fallen soldier, for a dignified burial in his hometown of Mobari Village, Chererezi Ward, Kijura Town Council.
Bring the body. We are hearing a number of programs. Though that is, yes, they lost the person, a very important person. Much of this person committed a crime, but he deserves a decent burial. My concern, Mr. Speaker, is can we get explanation of where are we getting our body?
Richard Tatina, the councillor representing Kijura Town Council, adds his voice to the plea. He emphasizes the importance of giving Private Sabiti a proper burial, regardless of any crimes he may have committed.
This is the person who has already gone, but as a family and as our culture, we feel like we need our body so that we bury our son.
Requesting for his body, for that we bury him, so that the children and the wife and the mother know that at least we buried our son, we buried our husband, we buried our father. It is very unfortunate that he shot the minister and then committed suicide. But there must be a reason.
Stephen Kagwera, the Member of Parliament for Buriaha, joins the discussion, stressing the necessity for a thorough investigation into the matter. He fondly remembers Private Sabiti as someone who displayed good behavior, and he believes his family deserves answers regarding his whereabouts and the timing of his burial.
We don't know really what happened. Perhaps if he was still living, he would have said, this is what happened. And perhaps he would have said, forgive me. But now, it cannot happen. What happened cannot be reversed. So really, it is very important and prudent that the parents and the relatives are not left in the dark. We should know when to bury.
With assurance that the Uganda People's Defense Forces will inform Private Sabiti's next of kin about the plans for bringing his body home for the final rites, the room exhales a collective sigh, understanding that the process will take time, but hopeful that their requests will be granted.
Assure the people that the army UPDF according to its code of conduct has procedures through which they apply whenever such an incident happens. We only request the bereaved family in Kijura to be patient.
Last week, UPDF officer Sabiti Wilson took the life of his boss, retired Colonel Charles Okello Engola, the State Minister of Labour, Employment and Industry Relations. Sabiti then turned the gun to himself at the minister's residence. Report compiled by Doreen Nasima for the news.